Hello everyone and welcome. In this video we're going to be talking about how the active aerodynamic system on the Lamborghini Huracán Performante actually works. And so, you know, there's two areas where this is going to be applying these active aerodynamic techniques. At the very front on the spoiler and then of course with the rear wing. And so how the front of this works is there's a little flap in that front spoiler, and so, you know, when it's closed, your air is going to pass through, go through your engine, radiator, etc., build up this high pressure area above that front spoiler, and then you'll have some air passing underneath, but you're going to have a lot of drag and you're going to have a lot of downforce. Now you have this little hinge right here which opens up this flap and allows that air that otherwise would build a high pressure area to escape underneath the vehicle, and so that's going to reduce the amount of drag that you have and also increase the amount of lift that you have. So you're going to reduce your downforce and you're going to reduce your drag, and so of course there are certain scenarios where this is ideal. Now for the rear wing, you have this channel where you're taking airflow from ahead and you're redirecting it upward toward the wing. And so what you have is this little hinge right here, this flap that can open or close. And when it is closed, you're going to have clean air along that rear wing above and below. So you're going to have nice flow that's connected to the wing and will produce that nice downforce as it's passing through. But you're also going to have a lot of drag as a result of creating that downforce. So when you open this valve right here, what that does is allow for the airflow to interfere with the smooth airflow underneath the wing. And so by separating that airflow beneath the wing, you're going to disrupt that low pressure side and create turbulent air behind it. And so ultimately what you're going to be doing by disrupting that airflow is reducing the amount of downforce that it's creating and reducing the amount of drag that it's creating. So, you know, what are some scenarios where each of these would be ideal? Well, under braking, you're going to have the ALA system off. That means both your valves are going to be closed. This is going to maximize your downforce in the front and the rear, and it's going to improve your braking, not only because you have more downforce to help brake with those tires, but you also have more drag to help slow the car down aerodynamically. With full throttle, you of course want to, if you're going straight ahead, you just want to be able to accelerate as fast as possible. So you're going to turn the ALA system on, it's going to open up both of these, so you're going to allow that air to channel through up the front, and you're going to allow the air to channel here, so you create that turbulence at the wing, and you don't have as much drag or downforce. So the car is going to be more slippery, able to accelerate quicker, and able to reach higher speeds. Now the interesting part where it kind of gets into this marketing twist rather than, you know, necessarily 100% engineering factor is this thing called aero vectoring. And so Lamborghini says that this will provide, you know, improved cornering speeds and reduce the amount of steering, the amount that you need to turn the steering wheel. Now this probably can be true. So let's say you're cornering and you put more. So what you're doing is as you go around that corner, you're putting more downforce on the inside rear tire than on the outside rear tire. And so if you're braking, if you're coming to that corner and you're braking, that inside left tire can have more grip to brake more, and as a result can help pivot the car, which means you don't have to use the steering wheel as much to pivot it. You can use the braking to help pivot it. That I do agree makes sense. You can also reduce body roll by having, you know, the car obviously is going to send load transfer to the outside tire as you're going around that corner, and by putting more aerodynamic pressure on the inside, you can help mitigate that body roll. I don't think that's the pure reason they've done that. You know, you can of course alter that with suspension settings. And so this claim about faster cornering, this is the interesting part, because if you have more downforce on the inside and less downforce on the outside, if your outside tire were to have more downforce, which it's capable of because you've opened up that flap behind it, you've got flaps on each side, so you know you can open one here and you can leave one closed here, so this has a lot of downforce and this one has less downforce, less drag, you could close this, have more downforce, give the outside tire more grip, and then in theory corner faster because you have overall more downforce. So I don't think from a cornering speed perspective this is helping. It could help you rotate in braking, that makes sense. It could certainly help reduce body roll, but I don't think it's necessarily going to improve your cornering speed. Another interesting thing that I think helps prove that point is that Lamborghini's head of aerodynamics was asked whether or not they used this aero vectoring in the front of the car. You know, you could have flaps on either side and open one side versus the other. He said they did not because there was no performance advantage. And so I think, you know, realistically, the huge advantage comes from braking in full throttle where you can alter it to suit those needs. That makes a ton of sense. For cornering, not quite as much, but perhaps you can use a little bit less steering angle because you're going to be braking that inside tire a little bit more. There are real advantages to a system like this, though, which I do want to point out. It's less weight. They say they can save up to 80% versus a hydraulic system simply using these little electric motors and not actually, you know, they're not taking a huge wing and moving it up and down and using all that hydraulic fluid and system required to do that. The wing is fixed. It stays there, and they simply alter the airflow around the wing in order to optimize it for the conditions that it's driving. It's also a very fast-acting system. They say they can open and close these valves in 0.2 seconds. So versus a hydraulic wing, you know, which may take more time to lift up or lower down, depending on the scenario you're in. So very fast acting. So both of those very real benefits for braking and for full throttle. I'm not totally convinced that in cornering, it's honestly going to make a huge difference. To me, the most logical approach, if you want the highest cornering speed, you want the most downforce you can possibly have. And so you would do that by just simply closing off these valves and allowing for maximum downforce. So if you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below. Thanks for watching.